Today we're going to be talking about 10 things good players do in zombies. You guys really enjoyed that video where I did 10 things noobs players do in zombies. That's exactly what I'm assuming. Hopefully you guys did enjoy that video though, and I decided to make a video about 10 things smart zombies players do in zombies, and aka pro players basically. And who knows, we may have a part 2 coming very soon for 10 things noobs do in zombies as well. If you spot anyone doing something newbie, don't hesitate. Put that shit in the comments. But these are going to be 10 things at no particular order. This is not a top 10, but 10 things video that good players do in zombies. And I highly doubt that you watching out there do all of them. Like, nah, that can't be real. But after you end up watching this video, hey, let me know in the comments what you do and what you don't do by dropping a number of that specific thing that I will mention in this video. But real quick, I want to shout out some of my brand new subscribers and homies. If you happen to be new on the channel, definitely hit that subscribe button for daily content and let me know in the comments so I can feature you in my next video. But coming in at number 10, we have that guy that will never steal your window kill. Like, it's a classic. If you guys remember Kino the Totem, or if you remember Ascension, or any zombies map, if you're playing with your friends or if you're playing with the randoms, like, I don't know how many people really play with randoms anymore, but if you do, drop a one in the comments right now so I know that you play with randoms. But there always going to be that one son of a gun that will be watching your window. But guess what? He's a good guy. He's really a good guy. He will be watching your window, but he won't come. Maybe he will just come to check what's up. He will be looking at your face and be like, "Do you need help, brother?" But you'll be looking back and, "Please, no. I don't want you to take my kills away." So he'll be just watching you, but he's a nice guy. He won't take your kills. He won't steal your points. None of that crap. He's a good guy, and that's one of the traits of the good zombie player. And if you actually have someone that doesn't steal your points, hey, you gotta embrace them. You gotta love them, have kids with, no, that's, we're going very far with that, but hey, you gotta embrace that guy, and you gotta play together every single day, or every time you play zombies, because he's a good zombie player. And there are always, like, other guys that will be watching your window, and as soon as they kill their zombie, they will be right where you are, and they will steal your kills. But that guy, that's a good guy, he will never do any of that. He's a good player, he's a smart guy, totally have kids with, I guess. But coming in at number 9, now this is the guy that will teleport together with everyone. Like, doesn't matter if he's playing with two guys, doesn't matter if he's only playing with one guy, doesn't matter if he's playing with three guys. That guy, as soon as the teleporter is ready, let's say in Kino the Totem or anything, like, if you're going for the Easter egg, or of course if you're doing Easter egg, then you have to teleport together. But what I'm trying to say here is that, let's say Mob of the Dead airplane or your transit bus, that's a quality meme right there. But this guy will leave with everyone. Doesn't matter if it's playing Kino the Totem, doesn't matter if it's playing Mob, doesn't matter if it's playing Transit, and doesn't matter with how many people he's playing with, he will wait, he will do a call out, he'll be like, "Guys, the teleportation or teleporter is ready, let's go ahead and teleport, let's pack a bunch of our guns, okay, so you don't have 5,000 points, don't worry, I'ma let you make points, and then we're gonna go next round," basically. That's a good trade, that's a beautiful trade of that good zombie player. If you see anyone doing that, embrace him, don't let him go, he's a quality guy. Coming in at number 8, now this is a guy I absolutely love. He's that guy that as soon as he see that fire sale, what he will do, he will just try to kill as much zombies as he possibly can. He will make sure that we're left with one zombie, and while he's killing zombies, he will do a call out. He'll be like, "Guys, I got a fire sale, it's crazy, just go to your position, you go there, you come with me." He'll do a call out, he'll say, "Fire sale is ready, just get your position, because it's gonna get real, man, shit gonna get real, so get your position, and let's keep one zombie alive." He'll do that, and sometimes what he will do is that if there are so many zombies, he will take those zombies, he will train, and he will let you use that fire sale. He's a good guy, absolutely embrace him. But coming in at number 7 spot, we have that guy that will always open doors for you. Doesn't matter how many points he has, he understands that you need help. He will just open doors, he will just go out of his his way. He doesn't give a damn. He will be like, okay, so you got 1k points, I have 750 points, guess what, I will open the first door. I mean, in a way, it's kind of like, yeah, he will open that the first door that costs less, but at the same time, he's very kind. He will open that first door, and you'll be the guy that will open the second door, but guess what, he'll be like, okay, so I'm gonna open the next door and the next door after that as well, because he understands he will get XP, but he's totally not doing that for gaining XP. Why he's doing that, I don't know. I really don't know. He's just a good guy. Coming in at number 6 spot. Now, this guy will share points if you are playing with him. And guess what? He will share those points if you're playing with him in transit. I don't know how many players I see doing that nowadays, but this guy will actually share points with you in transit. If you guys don't know how to share points in transit, basically you need the Galvic Knuckles and then you gotta go to the bank. And down here somewhere, I'm not sure if I'm gonna be able to find a screenshot or not, but if I do, I will put it on the screen. But around the bank area, you just need the Galvic Knuckle. You punch this little pingy type of thing and there you go. You will be able to give points to your teammates in transit. He's a good guy. Totally embrace him. You don't find players like this nowadays. Coming in at number 5. Now this guy will let you have the Wonder Weapon. It doesn't matter what map you're playing. This guy will be like, okay, so you need help? I got you, Nibba. I got you. If you're playing Shadows of Evil, this guy will let you have the Apothecan Servant. Now, I don't think you understand, like, how crazy this is. Like, I'm not even sure how many players do that nowadays. Like, let's be real. I tried to be 100% real with you guys, but I cannot get realer than this. Like, this guy will let you have the Apothecan Servant. He will make sure that he collects all the parts for you. He will be like, Nibba, I got you, don't worry, just kill zombies, I will collect all the parts, and as soon as it's done, I will go build it myself, but I will let you fist the Apothecan Servant or the Apothecan in his bumhole, if you get what I'm saying. Basically, that's how you put your hand in. Basically, you need to fist, don't even know why I'm talking, good meme. But he will let you have the Apothecan Servant. Same thing goes for the Raygun Mark II, the Thunder Gun, the Apothecan Servant in Revelations as well. It doesn't matter, this guy will let you have all of it. Coming in at number 4, reviving your teammates at right times. Now, this guy knows when to revive. He will always do whatever he can. He will get out of his way. He will take the matter into his own hands. Doesn't matter if you got the ray gun. Doesn't matter if you're screaming, revive me, I got a ray gun. Doesn't matter if you say, revive me, I got the Colt. He will revive you, period. He will make sure that you're up on your feet and you're well and you're standing tall. He doesn't give a damn. Even if there's a fire sale, that's the thing with that guy. If there's a fire sale and you're that guy that is constantly hitting the box, and guess what, you have went down, he doesn't give a damn. He will stop hitting his box and he will make sure that he use his Apothecan Servant or Thunder Gun, his Raygun Mark II, his SMR, doesn't matter, whatever he got, he will use it. He will make sure he take full advantage of that shit, and he will come to you and he will make sure there are no zombies. He will do a call out, guys, there's a skinny penis, he's down, just come, I need help, help me out here. we gotta revive this guy, and he will revive you, and then you'll be back. And guess what, fire sale is about to end, and there's only one person that can hit the box. Guess what, he will let you have the pleasure to hit that box. He's a good guy, totally embrace him. If you see anyone do that, definitely let me know in the comments, and definitely let me know his PSN ID, because I want to add him. So yeah, now I feel like all of you guys will be like, okay, so I'm gonna drop my PSN ID. But anyways, guys, my PSN is USMEN143, just add me, I'll add you back. So that's that. But coming in at number 3, now this guy knows what door to keep shut. Now, I was doing an open lobby just the other day. I legit had so much fun, but I swear, man, I was playing with 4 people, of course, including myself, and my homies actually opened the doors that were like, that we needed to keep shut. And for real, dog, my homies actually opened the doors that we needed to keep shut. Like, that door in the elevator in King of the Totem that you always want to have it shut. I'm also talking about another door that is behind the teleporter close to M16 Walby in the original King of the Totem, or in Black Ops 3, the M16 wall by. You know that door? Yes, that's the door I'm talking about. So my Nibba's actually opened that door, but this guy knows what door to keep shut. There are other maps such as Nagdar and Toten, you always want to keep the help door shut as well. You want to take the stairs, you know what I'm saying? But there are always some doors that are better off being shut, and this guy knows what door to keep shut. But coming in at number 2, Now, this guy will never interfere with your training area. Doesn't matter if he's low on ammo, doesn't matter. He will never interfere with your training area. He will make sure that he do a call out like 10 minutes prior to... No, I'm exaggerating. But he will do a call out prior to coming and interfering with your training area. He will make sure that you know that he's about to actually traverse your territory and your training area. He will buy the Shiva. If SMR was a wall buy, he will buy that, but he will never interfere with your training area. This guy knows what's up. He's a legit. He's considered God in zombies. Totally embrace him. But coming in at number one, now this is gonna like blow your mind. Now this guy, what he will do is that, for example, so if you're someone that just started playing zombies or you have been playing zombies for a while, but there's that map that you have never played and you're like, hey, let's spice things up. I'ma jump in on that map. Let's play with random. Or maybe I'll get a friend or two in it that are complete dumb. They are dumb, like you don't care about them, you just want to have them because they are your friends basically. So you wanna you got two of your friends, you got yourself, and you're looking for that fourth player but you cannot find. So guess what you do? You actually jump in that random lobby and you will find that random guy that will have like maybe rank 2 or 5 or 10, doesn't matter, but you're looking at him, he's looking at you, and you'll be like, what? And he's be looking at you saying what? And you'll be in your mind, you'll be like, okay, this guy's dumb, I don't know if we should play. But you will have that smart friend. He's not so smart, but he's a little smart. He will just say, okay, this guy is dumb, let's go ahead and play with him, let's laugh on his ass. So in that regards, he's pretty dumb too, but I mean, like, at least he's smart, because like he's actually gonna let that guy play with you. So what you do, you play with that guy, and guess what? You don't know about this map and you're totally counting on your friends to show you around, but they will never show you around. But that guy, that random ass dude, that's a good zombie player that will show you around. He will make sure you know how to get the shield parts. He will make sure where Juggernaut is located. He will make sure how to get the wonder weapon before your friends get it. He will make sure, he will never do anything for himself, but he will always do everything for you, because you don't know how this map works and you don't know how everything goes. And he's a good player, and mark my words, embrace him now, because it's going to be too late if you don't do it now. But anyways guys, let me know what you guys think in the comment section. What you do and what you don't do, let me know in the comments by dropping that specific number. And check out some other videos on the screen by clicking them if you have missed any of them. Subscribe if you happen to be new, and if you did enjoy this video, smash that like button, and I'll see you very freaking soon.